So R&D is important to both develop new products and to maintain the current existing products.
I oversee 3-4 functional departments within R&D, the silicones group, the urethane, air barrier, and new technology.
So they each are in charge of their own individual product lines, and we work together a lot. There's a lot of tests that we do that are ran together in the same way.
I really love what I do, trying to solve that puzzle and putting all the pieces together and coming up with that product that meets the project objectives and customer needs.
I think those little successes are some of the highlights of working in R&D.
A typical day for me is kind of diverse. It'll vary between doing some research, going to meetings, and then a lot of it is batch making and sample prep.
I read patents, I read literature.
We also get involved with the other groups within the commercial sealants and waterproofing division. That is the technical services group, also a product management group.
When we have a project, we'll work on a prototype. We like to take those out to a contractor. They'll give us their feedback and then we'll come back to lab and do some optimization.
So that information, some of it's internal, and sometimes if it's a finished product and it's ready to go to market, that information from the physical properties that we'll test will go onto the data sheet and that'll be published on our website.
R&D's, you know, in a role to be creative and to be innovative. So by default, we have almost absolute autonomy. But you know, I really just try to surround myself with my team, you know, make sure that their needs are met and they have all the tools that they need to be successful.
Based on the technology and capabilities that we work on, either with our raw material supplier partners or external partners, I think we are working on some pretty state-of-the-art technologies.
So things like phase change or biomimicry, I think there's lots of opportunity to look at different kinds of technologies that we've never even thought of before.
Tremco's a really good company. It's just not material in a tube, it's about, you know, connectivity. So from an environmental standpoint, I really enjoy, you know, the challenge of trying to make systems that make our buildings conserve energy and have longer lifespans.
It's really cool to know that something you've developed has the ability to be out there in the market, and when you finally see a product that you started in lab out on a building, that's a really good feeling to know that your work worked.